Hello everyone and welcome to yet another video podcast here on the War Bonds channel. If you don't know who I am, my name is Eric. I'm a locomotive engineer by profession, an avid model railroader, and just a lifelong rail enthusiast. Normally I'd be saying welcome to video number 10 of a series I've entitled called Building a 1-inch Scale Santa Fe GP60M. However, as you can also tell, I'm not actually at home. I'm actually out on the road. And I wanted to get this video started here because we're going to do something a little different. As we would say in aviation, we're going to make a little deviation. So if you were on an airplane and the pilot was going to deviate, you might hear something like, "Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, from the flight deck, this is your captain speaking. Due to a little weather ahead of us, we're going to be making a slight deviation to the north, but this should not affect our schedule and we should be looking at an on-time arrival due to a little pad in the schedule. We hope your travel's comfortable and thank you for flying with us today." Now, at this point, you're probably thinking, wait a minute, I thought he's a locomotive engineer. Am I? Or am I an airline pilot? I'll let you make the call on that. Whatever your opinion is, put it in the comments down below. Anyway, but I use that example because the weather represents the fact that we've been talking about the GP60M for quite a while. And I know that sometimes things can get a little technical with everything that I'm talking about. Unfortunately, that's just the way it goes when you're doing a project that is so complicated and complex. However, I thought, even for myself, like, let's just take a little break as far as the content that I'm providing, because even as the content provider, sometimes I get a little bored, and as the complexity continues to grow in this project, I wanted to just to take a step to the side a little bit so that we could look at something different. So what we're going to talk about today is a freight car that I started working on back in, I believe it was April of this year. So one of the things is I always loved building things. And I'm sure that after this GP60M project is done, I'm sure that I'll probably put other things that I start building on there as, or on the channel here as well. However, what ends up being a curse for me at times is I can be out somewhere looking at trains, or I can be on the internet or something and I see a really neat freight car, like, ooh, that's pretty cool. Man, I'd like to build one of those. I wonder if I could. Or sometimes I'm in a hobby shop and scale trains, Athern, Atlas, somebody comes out with a new HO scale car and I think, wow, that is so cool. And one of the reasons I got into 1-inch scale to begin with was back in 2017 when I got invited to the Chippewa and Northwestern Railway in Goner, Nebraska. And I saw what everybody was running and I thought, man, this is so cool. These trains are awesome. And I had transferred from HO scale to G scale at that time. But after seeing that stuff, I'm like, I think I want to go to this. And that's what got it started. Now, many of the people in the club there were running steam and first generation diesels, you know, a lot of older stuff. Now, in my heart, I'm a modern guy. And I thought I could be persuaded to build something, you know, that fits into that era that most of the people were running. But after a while, I decided there's no modern stuff. Well, maybe I could take my efforts and build some modern stuff. So if you haven't heard this story before, I think I may have explained it back before video podcast number one on the GP60M series, but I thought, I want to be a part of this. I want to do something. So what I ended up doing was trying to figure out how I could build something. Well, being a G-scaler at that time, I was actually scratch building a lot of modern stuff and had some things in some magazines and so forth. But now we're talking this big scale. What could I do? What can I build out of? Because I can't very well do styrene because it's just not going to hold up in the outside elements and the extreme temperatures. So I decided to go back to the days of junior high school when I was in shop class. And I hadn't worked with wood in years, but I thought, you know what? It's the only material that I've got that's going to hold up because I don't have any welding skills or anything like that. So let's give this a try. So I started building cars out of wood. Now, the funny thing is, and maybe some of you are already thinking this now, is that people would talk to me and I'd say, I'd maybe even be at the club, and I would say, since I am now a member of it, after a short time of seeing it, I decided I wanted to be a part of it. But I've told the strangers that, oh yeah, I build cars out of wood. And maybe it's a time that I've gone to the club and I didn't bring anything to run, and they're just like, you build cars out of wood, okay. And they kind of give me this look like, you're off your rocker, get away from me. And then I pull out my iPhone and I say, yeah, here's some of the stuff I built. And then all of a sudden their demeanor totally changes. Their eyes just bug out and they're like, that's a wood car? Like, yeah, it's wood. And then they want to talk to me. You're like, wow, how did you do this? So that's always an exciting thing, to show what can be done with the most unlikely materials. But anyway, so that's what this is going to be about. So what started out as a hopper car, a two-bay hopper car, I believe it was a sodium chlorate car. And I'll put a picture up there. It's painted up in Procore. Now, Procore is a company in Canada, and it's kind of like GATX here in the United States. But it's a leasing company. And if you've spent any time around the railroad, you've probably seen their tank cars. They run a lot of propane tank cars, big, huge, like maybe 68-foot cars. And they also have some hopper cars as well that they lease out. So they're primarily a Canadian company. But anyway, I saw this car and I thought, wow, that's really neat. I'd like to do this. So I started working on it, started building it, and then all of a sudden, things didn't go very well with it. I made some mistakes on it, and then I decided, well, let's scratch this idea and try to do something else. So there's another Canadian company, actually. Maybe you've seen their cars, but they're like salmon, kind of salmon orange looking cars, and they have the words potash on the side. And let me show you a picture of that as well. So I decided that I was going to do one of these cars. Well, by the time it was all said and done, I talked to management, aka the wife, and I said, hey, what do you think about this? I think this would be really cool. Well, her favorite color is green. So it turns out this same company had merged with another potash company, and they started painting these cars green. And when my wife saw that, you know, she goes, well, it's a no-brainer. What do you think? You know, so this is what I ended up doing with the car, and painted it green. But it took quite a bit of time to get the car done, and there was a train show down in Deschler, Nebraska, back in July, and I was hoping to get the car done for that show, but it didn't happen. And I almost decided not to go to the show because the car wasn't done, until I got chewed out by my 9-year-old daughter that, you promised us we're going to this show, so even if you don't have the car done, bring what you've got. So, okay, yes, ma'am. You know, this is from the 9-year-old. So anyway, I ended up taking the car, and after the show, well, I guess I just kind of lost my drive to work on it. So it kind of sat dormant for about 3-4 months. And then recently I decided I wanted to start working on it again. So I just got it finished. So that's what this video is going to be about. I'm going to show you some of the in progress photos, and I'm going to take you on location to Goner, Nebraska, where I actually took the car yesterday in order to do some photography on it. And I'll talk to you a little bit about some of the details and the features that I put on it. So let's get ready to take a little on location trip to Goner, Nebraska. Well, here we are, Governor, Nebraska, Chippewa and Northwestern Railway. I have gotten to experience the joyous moment of putting my 47-foot Potash hopper car on the tracks for the first time. And let me tell you, it's always a great moment every time I build a car and I have this joyous moment. So I am just excited, but I'm gonna be doing some photography of this car and just kind of pushing it around. Normally my kids are here acting as my switch engine to move it around for me, but unfortunately my son was a little naughty this morning and they're both in school. However, at this moment, it's 35 degrees out, so I'm kind of freezing here, so I'm going to make this fairly quick here, but I just want to be able to bring you out on location so that we can actually see it on the tracks and we can witness the moment when it first touches the rails. Job 02, give me a little kick. Well, she rolls pretty good. I've been going around shooting stills of the car, and this railroad is just, it's fabulous when it comes to all the different locations that I can shoot and video and things. It's just wonderful. But I'm just going to give you a little run around of the car here, just to show you all the things that I've done to it. But this is, in case I didn't mention it before, this is all made out of poplar wood. I choose to use poplar because it's a very hard wood, but it takes way more abuse than, say, a softwood like pine. I would never try to build anything like that out of pine. But anyway, it's gone together pretty good. You know, like everything, it's got its flaws, but, you know, it makes me happy just to see the fruits of my labor. But I mentioned in another video with the Jeep 60M that I use the Cricut machine to do a lot of my lettering. So as you can see here, the Nutrien is based off of lettering that I took off of the internet and was able to put it into the Cricut program and Photoshop and work on it in order to get what we wanted out of it. So it actually came out exact the way it's supposed to be.
Now, granted, there's a little bit more lettering that needs to go on it. For instance, I don't even have lettering on the ends of the car. I don't really have much more than the car reporting marks. So the initials, POTX, and then the number 2897. But I've got that on both sides, but otherwise, it needs a little bit more. And as you can see on the little seams there, I actually made them a little too big, but I wanted to just try to do the best I could. I was really experimenting with using what I had or what I had access to, so it's really not too bad though, but I'll put a little weathering on it to, since a lot of dirt tends to run down the seams, so that'll make things a little bit better. But the roof walks, I actually found some perforated metal at Menards. And even though the holes are a little big, which you might not be able to tell because as I'm shooting this, I mean, it still looks pretty darn good. But anyway, yeah, we got that. And on the business end, or what we call the B end, which is because we've got the some of the brake rigging and the brake wheel and everything. Of course, then the other end would be called the A end. Let me see if we can go in a little bit here. I ended up putting some brake piping in there and got a triple valve in there. I don't know if we can really get in there. There we go. So, got that going on. Actually got a brake pipe hose there and the angle cock there. And so it's really got a lot of detail on it, you know, for, you know, no more than I did, which I say that humbly, but I really tried to do the best I can to make a pretty good representation. But one of the eyesores of it is that, as you see, the side is actually flat. Now on these cars there's actually a little bit of a curvature, but you know what, I could only do so much with this car, and you can only do so much with rigid wood. So that's one of the things that didn't happen. But look at the car like this, you'd really never be able to tell. So it actually still came out as a pretty good representation for what I wanted. Well, I think I've done about all I can do as far as views around the layout to be able to shoot this beautiful car. And but it's cold outside. It's in the 30s. I'm slightly freezing my tuchus off, so we're going to call it good for today. But I hope you've enjoyed this, a little deviation from the GP60M project, and get a chance to see something else that I actually do. And I think I'll probably make a few more videos showcasing each of the different projects that I've done. Not to say that I've done a whole lot, but I have several cars that I've built. So perhaps I can give a little slide montage of what I've done with each of those projects as well in later videos. But I hope you've enjoyed this content today. And if you do enjoy this content, I would invite you to like and subscribe to my video and my channel. Thank you.